girls, welcome back to the channel. I feel so distant from you guys because my uploads recently have been so pre-filmed. It's probably been around 2 weeks since I've actually sat in front of the camera. So I thought I'd film something that would make me feel a little bit closer to you guys. So I'm gonna film a Q&A. I haven't done one of these in such a long time, but I also have a lot to discuss with you guys. Yeah, I just feel like being really honest and open with you guys. So yeah, this video is gonna be super chilled out. Grab some food, grab a cup of tea, grab whatever you want, and let's just sit and chat for a bit. So I got you guys to ask me questions over on my Instagram. If you do ever wanna get involved in these kind of videos, or you're just curious what I look like on the gram, then definitely head over and follow my Instagram. But you guys went in. I said don't hold back and you definitely didn't. The first one is, how's your hay fever? I feel like you can tell from my voice. The reason that I'm doing such a laid back video is because I have no energy at all. My hay fever is completely wiping me out. Luckily, today and tomorrow is really low on the pollen count, so that's why I'm trying to get some videos out for you guys, because the next few days I'm literally gonna be immobile. I don't know, it's just hitting everyone so much stronger this year. So my hay fever is a bit poop, but I'm getting in there. I'm just hoping my antihistamines like get into my system. Hopefully I'll be okay. Where are your bandanas from? So this one is from Misguided. It's super cute. I haven't worn this one yet and I'm absolutely loving it. But the majority of my bandanas, a lot of them are vintage, so blue rinse vintage, or they're from Lavisa. That was where I first started getting my bandanas from when I initially started wearing them. Can't even remember how many years ago, probably 2 years ago. But they seem to be everywhere at the minute. I mean, go on whatever clothing website you want and type in bandana or headscarf and I'm pretty sure it will come up with some. Are you still on your pill? Because I'm scared with the one that I've started. So I am still on the Aspirin pill. I haven't taken it today. Oh my god, you just reminded me that I haven't took my tablet today. Let me just go do that. So the pill that I'm on is the Yasmin pill. This one is doing me so well. Obviously, if you guys have followed me for a while, you'll know that I went on the pill to clear my skin. And I know I've got makeup on, but I haven't really had a spot in a month or two. I mean, there's obviously gonna be days where I have like the little pimple, because remember, we're in extremely hot weathers right now. We're wearing masks all the time. I'm not very well. I'm constantly wiping my nose because of hay fever. I have seen some blemishes around my nose, but that's just normal. I would definitely say the Aspirin pill is working. I'm not gonna advise you guys to go on the Aspirin pill because I'm not a doctor, but just know it's worked for me. And if it's something you're interested in, then definitely go to your doctor. Don't be scared. I know there is a lot of scary stuff online, but you also need to remember that there are so many people on the pill as well, and we're all okay. If you ever have any health worries or issues or just any queries about your pill, you can definitely just speak to your doctor. And if you think your pill is not right for you, if you like immediately as soon as you start taking it you're like, this is not right for me, then definitely go to your doctor and ask if you can come off and change to another one, because you know your body better than anyone. So I wouldn't be scared or frightened of it. There is definitely enough time for you to come off it and change. Why doesn't your boyfriend post about you? So I find this question really funny because I do social media, it's my job. Like, my life is social media, posting on Instagram, posting on YouTube. So naturally I'm gonna post my boyfriend a fair bit, just because he's in my life. It's the same as what I do with friends when we go out for meals or if we're just hanging out. And keeping you guys updated with my life is part of my job. I want to keep you entertained and up to date with what I'm doing in my day-to-day life. It's not his job to do social media, but he's also not in the cycle that I am necessarily to always post and let people know what he's doing, because that's just the way I'm conditioned to be because of the job that I do. But he isn't. Like, luckily he has a normal life and he isn't conditioned to always post on social media. So that question makes me laugh because it's just the way that we are. Like, I prefer it that way. And I know some people are gonna find that weird. Some people are even gonna find it weird in general that we post online together, because I know a lot of people like to keep their relationships private, completely off social media. But I'm a bit of a mix of both. We like to share some things if we get a cute photo together, but majority of the time it's private. Do you ever wish you weren't in the public eye? It's quite difficult to answer that one, because as much as I would love to not have hate online or just extreme pressures of just having to do everything right, because you've got so many eyes on you at all times, you also want to be a really good influence. It's really, really difficult because I'm still learning, I'm still growing, I'm only 21. Back in the day, I used to have the excuse of, oh, I'm still a teenager, I'm still learning, but I don't understand why you can't still be learning at 21. I'd like to say I'm completely knowledgeable on everything and I'm right on everything and I'm teaching everyone good things, but I'm just a normal person, so it's quite difficult. And that's why I don't like to call myself an influencer, because I'm just someone someone living my life, this happened really naturally for me, and I'm just documenting it and just having fun and just trying to entertain people. So I don't like to call myself an influencer because I don't see myself as influencing people in my day-to-day life unless they see something positive and take from it. I wouldn't really say I'm in the public eye as such because I don't class myself as famous or like even a Z-lister or just anything like that. Like, I just see YouTube and Instagram. But there have definitely been times where the hate's got too much, or I just couldn't go outside without feeling super anxious and just as if like I couldn't do anything right. There's definitely been those times where I've been like, I just wish I didn't have to do social media, I wish it wasn't my job, I wish it wasn't this. But then I just realized how selfish I was, because I am so lucky to be in the position that I am, to have the platform I do, to have you guys. And in those moments, I never ever ever wanted to give up that. There's just certain aspects like the hate that you would want to give up or just not have. When is your birthday? So I feel like if you're a new follower, you might not know this because I haven't mentioned it in a long time, but my birthday is the 28th of July, which means it's coming up soon. I'm so excited. I don't know what I want to do for my birthday. I think I want to do a themed night. I think I want to get my friends to dress up as Cluedo characters and play like live Cluedo. That sounds really weird, but imagine your favorite board game, mine is Cluedo, and turning it into real life. I think that would be so cool. Is there anything you regret sharing online? Love you. I love you too. Never regret anything in my life. I definitely think you can learn from your mistakes, and you have to make mistakes in order to know what's right and wrong and in order to never do them again. I don't really think there's anything I regret sharing, because sometimes oversharing is good. I like being open about sexuality, masturbation, taboo topics, my health. There isn't really anything I could regret putting online. I know a lot of people will probably be like, well, what about your sex talks? But no, I'm pretty happy. Voila. There you go. How did you meet your boyfriend? So the story of me and Brad is quite funny. I actually was on Instagram one day, just on my explore page, and I saw Brad. I went on his profile, saw he was a model and stuff, and I just generally found him really attractive. So I gave him a follow. I went to message him, but before I could, he messaged me saying something like, hello beautiful, or aren't you beautiful, something like that. And ever since then, we were talking for a little bit. This was back in October time. We spoke, we had some phone calls, and we didn't FaceTime or anything, so I really did think he was a catfish. I thought he was a fake account because I was just like, there's no way that this person is talking to me and looks like that and is this kind and is talking to me. And then one day I woke up and we just didn't speak. He just didn't message me back, and it was like that for about 3 months. I thought, right, there's no bad blood there, it just didn't work out. We still followed each other and I still looked at all of his stuff and looked from a distance and still fancied him, you know, it's one of those. I didn't block him, I didn't like go on a rampage, because I was just like, that's life. And then 3 months later, he messaged me out of the blue saying, I think I'm falling in love with you. And it was to do with one of my covers. I can't remember for the life of me which one. I think it was Girl Put Your Records On. And we've been talking ever since. I mean, we are actually together now, guys. I know, contrary to belief. The relationship has only been like a month or so, but we've been talking since God knows when. But that's the story of how I met Brad. We always laugh about it whenever people ask how we meet. We're always like, oh, well, he ignored me for 3 months. But there was no like hard feelings, and I think that's why it worked out so well. I didn't have a drastic reaction, like I didn't flip out or anything. And I know a lot of people would just be like, fuck you, done with my time, like I'm blocking you, I'm not letting you ever come back. But sometimes people just aren't ready for relationships. They're not ready to be talking to someone and dedicate the whole time to someone. And if you just let life take its course, let you have that separation and just carry on with your life and be independent and just, you know, you do you, life will eventually come back round to do what it was supposed to do, but at the right time. That's what I think. If me and Brad didn't work out, I definitely would have said it was right person, wrong time. I strongly believe in that. I don't care what anyone says. I believe in that so, so much. But luckily, it was our time. Have you had any plastic surgery or fillers? By the way, I love your videos. Thank you so much. Yes, I have had filler. I haven't had any plastic surgery, but I have had filler here, all down my nose, and a little bit in the tip to just like raise it up a bit. And I've also had it in my Cupid's bow. I did have it initially like in my whole lip area, but I wasn't really too happy with that. So instead, I just had it in my Cupid's bow to make my lips look more defined. Doesn't really necessarily do much for the size of your lips. It just creates a nice little Cupid's bow, which I don't know if you can even see. But aside from that, I am au naturel. Are you friends with Saffron? I know, daredevil question, LMAO. See, I always get this and I always used to ignore it because it was really weird to me. It's like asking if I'm friends with Freya. Of course, I am friends with Saf. I know, contrary to the belief, for some reason people think that if you don't post with someone online, you're not friends with them anymore, which is just a very weird concept. I don't get that. I'm very happy to say that I have a lot of friends just because I don't talk to them 24/7 or comment on their photos or see them 24/7, bearing in mind the year that we've just been through. It doesn't mean that I'm not friends with them. I have honestly had this question so much over the past year, and sorry to disappoint you guys, but yes, we are friends. Are you moving out by yourself, and are you gonna miss living with Byron? If so, so I am gonna move out by myself. My move out date final is August 14th. I know this is probably a shock to you all. And no, I don't hate Byron. I'm not moving in with my boyfriend. I'm not moving in with Byron. I'm not moving in with Anna, Freya. I'm not moving in with anyone. I'm living by myself, which I've always said I will never do. I'm very scared. Luckily, I have all of my friends around me. I'm not moving too far. Obviously, we have Byron here, Freya, Anna. Brad is also moving to Manchester literally next week. So there's gonna be a lot of us in a close little circle, and that makes me very confident that I'll be able to live by myself. Me and Byron have never lived by ourselves for the 4 years, 5 years that we've lived together. It's always been with other people as soon as we moved out of home. And now that we've both got partners, obviously, if we end up spending the rest of our lives with our partners, which we hope, there will never be a chance to live by ourselves again. So we thought at the end of this tenancy that we will just experiment for a year. We'll just see how we cope living alone, get that independence, try it out. And I think it's really good that we get to do that, because if we just went straight into living with our partners and then we did for the rest of our lives, we never got to experience it. And I think that can be really bad. I highly encourage everyone to try and live by themselves at one point, even if it is for a few months. I think a year is quite long, but that's the only tenancy that I could get at the place I wanted to live. So that leads on to the next question. Do you think you and Byron will stay as close when you move? I don't see how we can't be. It sounds really weird, but Byron's one of those people that if I don't see him for a whole year, don't speak to him for a whole year, I will then see him again and be as close to him as I always have been. It would be as if nothing has changed. And I also just love him far too much to not be close to him anymore. So I don't see us drifting at all. If we do, I will be having a strong talking to him, because I'm not letting it happen. Are you doing a podcast of your own? So when I was initially planning to move out, the place I was looking at had like this really cute glass room. It was honestly adorable. And I wanted to turn that into a podcast room, but I'm not moving there anymore. So I don't know what I'm gonna do. Hopefully I could turn part of my kitchen into a podcast room. But of course, I definitely wanna start up my podcast this year. You guys know I wanna do the People's Diary podcast, and I wanted to do it for so long. It's just life has just got in the way. But I promise podcasts will definitely come at some point this year. I'm forcing myself. My manager already knows about it. Do you have any Netflix suggestions? So any cooking program. I'm loving cooking programs at the minute. I love like MasterChef and all of that. But then there's this other one called The Family Showdown. Something like that. Oh my God, it's so good. I don't know what it is about cooking programs. I think maybe because I like watching mukbangs and I like watching eating shows. Like I will watch someone have a full seafood platter without them talking. I just like to watch them eat it. But I hate the sound of people eating. I have to turn that part down. Are you ever worried that your younger years are flying by and you're losing time? I told you guys to go deep and I didn't know you were going like life deep. I am. I used to have this thing when I was younger where I would never sleep at night because I was scared of wasting time. I mean, all I'd be doing is sitting there watching a Netflix program. But I thought in my head, if I don't watch this now, when am I ever gonna watch it? I just never used to sleep. I used to go into my nan's room and I used to just like sit there with my nan and cry because I thought I was wasting my life. But even now, yes, of course, I worry that I'm wasting life. Even me sat inside here because I don't want to go out and get my eyes in flames, I'm sad because I want to go out and experience life. But I then just have to think about it as hopefully I've got many and many years to obviously go out and live my life. I'm hoping to achieve everything I want to within my lifetime and just take every single day as it comes. Do you think Manchester is where you'll live in the long term? I do. My brother lives here and he's lived here for quite a few years. I love Manchester in general. I love living in a city. I love love how much a city has to offer and how easy it is to get around, how everything is just on your doorstep. I'm too much of a people person to live in an isolated area. So I think I'll move out the city eventually when I get older, probably like 25, something like that. I'm hoping to go traveling before that. I really want to go traveling. I ought to be traveling around Australia right now. I ought to be going around India and discovering all these new spices. Oh. What is your apartment or housing plans for the future? Obviously, be moving out in August, but then I also want to buy a place soon. I want to buy somewhere and do it up, and maybe not live in it for a few years. Maybe I'll buy it and do it up so that I can rent it. Maybe I'll do it in the next couple of months. I'm just trying to be strategic about my money because I don't want to waste it. There's your answer. When is your next holiday when you're allowed to go? I don't know. I want to get both my vaccines before I go away because I would hate to be that person that goes somewhere and then brings it back into the country. But I also want to make sure that I'm safe going away and then I'd be safe coming back to my family. So I just kind of want to wait until everyone's had their vaccines. I haven't had mine yet, but I'd rather just everything here be okay before I go away. As much as I want to go to Portugal, as much as I want to go back to Greece, I think Greece will probably be one of the first places I go to because I just love it. Or Spain. Possibilities are endless. I can dream. How are you feeling mentally? I hope you're in a good place. Thank you so much. That is so sweet of you. I just feel really chilled. I don't know if you can tell from this video, just because I'm really low in energy today. I just feel really like floaty above the clouds kind of vibe, probably because I'm so bunged up, but overall I am so good. Every aspect of my life is good. Yeah, I'm kind of excited to just get moving. I'm looking at all of the furniture and stuff. The place I'm getting is unfurnished, and obviously guys, you are going to be seeing the vlogs of me going to get my furniture and designing the place. I'm so excited, but I'm good. Thank you so much for asking. And on that amazingly positive note, guys, I'm gonna love you and leave you here. Groovy girls, if you do want to submit anything to the people's diary or tub talks, of course there will be new ones coming soon. I hope you enjoyed the last two. You can check the link tree down in the description and you can find the forums there. Remember, if you do want to follow my Instagram, it is on the screen. I don't know why I'm talking like a TV host, but I'm gonna go. I love you so much, groovy girls, and I will see you in the next video.